Hey guys, Nick here. So today we're going to be taking a look at the item upgrade feature coming in 5.1 and currently available for testing on the PTR. So let's look at it as more of an overview to start off with the fact that all items and the way that their tooltips look, it's all changed. No more green text below all the requirements. Instead, it's a nicely laid out with all the primary stats, then all the secondary stats in green just below. Now we'll also note that the item level is at the top, along with the note of which upgrade level it's on. So we'll get right to it. Now 5.1 will spawn these item upgrade NPCs pretty much wherever you would normally expect to find a reforge or a transmog guy. And with this vendor, he gives you the ability to upgrade any 4, 5, 8 item level gear pieces or higher to further improve them. Now, this opens a huge bag of tricks for a lot of raiders and PvPers, all trying to min-max the best way that they can as quickly as they can, so that they're going to have to work out which item is going to be best to upgrade first. Now on your screen you'll see the table that was featured a few weeks ago explaining how the Valor can be used on PvE epics to upgrade them by 4 item levels 2 times, and Honor can be used to upgrade 8 item levels only once. And the same goes for Conquest and Justice points for PvP Blues and Epics. The whole public service announcement of this video is just to make sure everybody is putting in that little extra effort to make sure that they're capping their points every week to make upgrading your gear as painless as possible. A few things to note from what I've picked up while messing around with it in the way that I have is that currently any upgrades that you do are completely unrefundable, which is kind of daunting when you want to mess around with it. And another thing to note is that each single item abides by those cost listings shown in the previous chart, meaning that any two-hand wielder has a bit of an easier total upgrade cost, but when it comes to it, two-handed wielders will fall short on those extra stats because the one-handers increase at the same rate. I'm not sure how they're going to go about that. It rings bells with what the PvP item costs were at the start of the season. So I hope they take note of that. But that's about it from me, guys. This is probably one of my favorite features hitting in 5.1, along with a sneaky clip that I'll hopefully end up getting for you pretty soon. And I think everybody's been looking forward to this ever since it was mentioned all those BlizzCons ago. But thanks very much for watching, guys. Cheers.